So I packed up and I made up to New York.
Derringer, singer, musician, record producer.
Frankenstein almost didn't make it on the album, and I don't think anybody ever expected it to be released as a single.
With Edgar Winter.
Trying to get it when no one gives me a try. Why am I dying to live if I'm just living to die?
And the Edgar Winter Group.
I went right out of high school into a hit record, Hang On Sloopy. That time I was playing guitar and singing with the McCoys. We had several other chart records, but Hang On Sloopy was definitely the biggest one. I met Edgar Winter while helping co-produce one of his brother Johnny's albums. That time Edgar was doing his first album, which was definitely an album for himself only. It had jazz and classical and some rock in it. Didn't seem to be a really commercial kind of album. After that, Edgar went into a different kind of direction, got together a group called White Trash, which was a New Orleans-y, Texas kind of rock and roll band, and I helped him make the White Trash album. About that time, I joined the band, joined White Trash, and went on the road with him. After about 4 weeks, I came to Edgar and I said, hey, I just can't do this anymore. I've been doing it for 7 years almost, and I have to rest. I think my time has come. But as it turned out, I kept playing with him until the Roadwork album was finished. Then at that time, he got a new band together and went in a new direction, which is what he's doing now. It's a smaller band, can do pretty much whatever kind of music he wants. He isn't restricted by any kind of limitations anywhere. And there's a song, as a matter of fact, called Keep Playing That Rock and Roll that seems to explain pretty well how Edgar got involved in the business.
Don't you know that I was sitting back in bed? So I packed up and I made up to New York. You know that I've been doing lots of things. Yeah.
Hi, Edgar.
Hi, Rick.
I think everybody'd probably be interested in knowing how that song came about.
Well, it's my true life story, in a sense. It tells how I came from Texas to New York, and also how I came from music into the music business. It is sort of a satire, but yeah, it's all true.
Well, you've been on the road for about 2.5 years now. Does it seem to be getting any better?
I'm enjoying it more, you know, but if you keep your energy up, yeah, and take care of yourself,
you gotta take care of yourself.
Yeah, if you don't, you'll find yourself sort of crazy. The thing about the road is it's difficult to write, which is one of the things that seems to always bother me, because I'm really interested in writing.
Yeah, there never
almost
seems to be
primarily
enough time.
Yeah, plus that, just the whole effect of the road changes your ideas and your attitudes, the way you relate to things and what actually you would write. Say, Keep Playing That Rock and Roll, for example, is more typical of a song that you would write on the road,
yeah,
whereas the song which I'm about to do, Dying to Live, was written at a time when I was in between bands, sort of down and depressed, and through writing the song, I came to feel better. It helped me just feel better about myself, what I was doing, and I can only hope that those who listen to it will feel the same way.
Thank you.
I'm ready to die.
Frankenstein almost didn't make it on the album, and I don't think anybody ever expected it to be released as a single.
Actually, it was a song that I had written some 2-3 years ago when I was playing in my brother Johnny's band, and it was written for a double drum solo. One of our big numbers.
It was always called Double Drum Solo,
wasn't
it? Right,
we called it the Double Drum Solo.
Didn't even have a name.
Later, when I started getting into the synthesizer, I needed a, you know, a song. So I just adapted the double drum song, and then we started calling it the synthesizer song. There was a lot of talk about how much editing was done. The tape was really cut to pieces, and that was one of the ways in which the name Frankenstein applies. The song seems to fit the title. That's what I like about it. And it is visual type of music that you can see pictures,
right,
you know, when you're listening to it.
I don't really think of myself as a producer. Sometimes I'm not even sure there is such a thing as a producer. What I try to do in the control room is just work with all the people, make sure they know what they want to do, and then help them do it. Cooperation is the main thing. Sometimes I even play various instruments, whatever's needed, with the band myself. I think the record should reflect not really my taste, but it should reflect partly my taste and everybody in the group, and hopefully the people that are going to buy the record too. Hope you enjoyed the music we did today.